We've learned how we gather really matters. And so here are some guidelines for how we gather.
Welcome to Courageous Community, where together we are building greater inclusion and belonging. We're your hosts, Zena Jacques and Jessica Green, coming to you from Barrington, Illinois, home of the pilot series, A Year of Courageous Conversations.
Whether you have been part of this community from inception or are just joining us, you are welcome here. In order to create a space of shared trust, we frame our gatherings within the grounding virtues of the On Being Project. Here, we strive to practice hospitality, humility, patience, generous listening, and adventurous civility, and the notion that our words matter.
Intentionally being in community with one another takes conscious effort. It is a choice and a practice. Here are some tips for engaging mindfully throughout this work. Be present. Turn off your phone and other media devices. Say no to thoughts that have nothing to do with the conversation you are having. Be other focused. Immerse yourself in every word that is spoken. Listen to the tone of the other person's voice. Listen using your eyes. Suspend judgment. Attempt to truly understand what the other person is saying without judgment, criticism, or defensiveness. Different from a debate or competition, the goal is understanding and truth-seeking. Respond versus react. Listen. Take a breath. Respond. Pay attention to what feelings arise. And take breaks. This is both head and body work. If you feel tense, step out for water, fresh air, or a stretch.
We believe inner work is required for ourselves when we come into courageous conversations with others. To help create the space for both personal transformation and that of our community, we set the following intentions. When one person is talking, others should be listening. Avoid interrupting, talking over one another. Do this in order to honor and respect each voice.
What's said here stays here. What's learned here leaves with you. This should be a place where people can share personal stories and not worry about that being discussed outside of the room.
Step up, step back. If you're someone who tends to talk a lot, like me, challenge yourself to let others talk first. And if you're someone who tends to hold back, challenge yourself to contribute a little more. Be aware of how much space you're taking.
Use I statements. Everyone is entitled to their feelings, as long as they are sharing from their own personal experience. Avoid speaking on behalf of others or making broad assumptions or generalizations about groups of people.
We are all learning. We should have badges that say we are learners. If you know a lot about a subject, try to remember that at one time you were just beginning. Be patient with people who are just beginning.
Care for each other. This is hard work, and it's easy to take our stress out on one another. Be gentle and kind with yourself and with each other.
Stay curious. The greatest threat to civility and ultimately to civilization is an excess of certitude. Get uncomfortable. Change doesn't happen when we stay comfortable. But we are designed to seek comfort. Bryan Stevenson teaches, in brokenness, we understand what it means to be human. And this is my favorite. Stay hopeful. Hopelessness is the enemy of justice. Another thing Bryan Stevenson teaches. He says, we each have a responsibility to protect our own hopefulness and to believe things are possible even when we haven't seen them yet. Hope is what gets in us and helps us stand up when other people tell us to sit down. The entirety of this pilot year is available to you on our website, courageousconversations.us. And whether you're new to this journey and this work or have been with us from the beginning, we encourage you, strongly encourage you, to revisit the website the whole first season, because it lays out the foundation from which we continue to build courageous community.
Thank you for walking this path with us.